What's up, guys? Starting a stream here. Gonna play some cash games. Pretty much playing the equivalent of around 5-10 or so online. Playing two different games on WPT Global. And pretty excited. I haven't done a cash game stream in a long time, so it should be pretty cool. I've been doing a couple more streams lately, but those have been satellites for the WPT WPT World Championship, but got two games going. They're 10, 20, 40 renminbi. So I'm actually up a couple thousand already today. I've been trying to get this stream set up, haven't really been playing well, but I've just been running absolutely insane, which is awesome. But yeah, it's tough to play good poker and get the stream set up because there's just a ton of things kind of going on all at once. But this is on a 3-minute delay and pretty excited to just hang out. I've got sorry, we got involved in a hand over here. We're raising with ace jack. Got a new vlog coming out tomorrow. I'm going to start doing these at least twice a week, thanks to WPT Global helping me. They're paying for an editor, so that means I can play a lot more poker, and I am able to create a lot more content. So that's been really, really helpful. I've actually been making two vlogs per week. Jesus. But I've only been releasing one. That's gonna change in December. I've been saving them up. Yeah, let's look for a better spot here. But I'm in for 6,000 renminbi on both of these games. You can see I've got almost 13,000 in this game here. And I actually played a high stakes session for like two hands, and I turned quad aces, so I hit a jackpot bonus on it. So maybe I'll record that, or I have it recorded. Maybe I'll share that with you guys at some point. Get a min raise here? Oh no, sorry. Not a min raise. Gotta promote this stream real quick. All right, as soon as this is actually live, oh, there we go. Here we go, I see you guys in the chat now. The delay is over, so yeah, feel free to ask me anything you want in the chat. I'm happy to answer pretty much anything, anything reasonable. As long as I see it. But good to see you guys. Alex Toth. Brad, welcome to my stream. Alright. This is your stream, Alex. That's cool. Walter, hello, Brad. You're awesome. Big Country DG, disabled veteran here. Definitely help with my PTSD watching your videos. That's awesome, man. Always glad to, like, just the fact that anybody enjoys these videos. I appreciate. And if it helps anybody in any way, that's pretty cool. All right, still gotta... Got this up. 357 people in here. Let's go. Let's just crush some people. I think I'm up a couple thousand already today. So I think I had about 35,000 in the account when this started. Now I've got 1,600, 2,400, a little over 38,000. So, if you're just joining, I made quads earlier in a hand before I started the stream, and I was just trying to get everything set up. Seb J says, your videos will still be edited in identical style, I hope. Yeah, all the videos have been edited by the editor for the last like 2 months actually that you've seen on the main channel. But I've been doing two videos a week on there. And, I've been making two videos a week, but I've only been posting one video a week. I've been saving up those other ones. I have like 8 in the pipeline that are 90% finished. I just need to, you know, add some finishing touches, shoot the intros and outros for them and do a few things like that. But, I'm still writing scripts 100% myself. That's where my voice and personality comes out. Can't outsource that since no one knows what's going on in my head as I'm playing hands. It's been going really well. Views haven't been up quite as much, unfortunately. Two hands we're playing here. Tomorrow actually is going to be the second vlog of the week. We put out one Monday, and then tomorrow's December 1st. I'm going to put out one... following Monday as well. Just gonna fold this ace queen here. So tomorrow, December 1st, and then Monday, and then Monday and Thursday every week in December is when we're gonna have new vlogs come out. So be sure to check those out. They'll be coming out at 10 a.m. Pacific time. So, 47 indigo. Sir, someone asked, why is he playing in Juan? We're playing on WPT Global. A lot of people play from Asia, which kind of makes these games pretty good. We have the ace of hearts here. I guess we're not... Am I not even showing you guys the right game? Here we go. Put in a little check raise. He doesn't really have that much behind, so if he jams, I guess they're just gonna fold. Yeah, fuck. Went for it, didn't work out. Tom Diamond says, any plans to come to the UK soon? We actually were trying to get something lined up with Ireland. In Dublin. I mean, I don't think parts of Ireland consider themselves the UK. I think like split between Northern Ireland and Southern Ireland or whatever. But we were trying to get something lined up in Dublin, but we're kind of running into some roadblocks. We're trying to go there in January, and it might just be a little bit too short of a runway to get something lined up. Dream says, who... No, okay, so let's see, what was I going to say here? I saw a question that I wanted to address. Mobile 5 to 10 minutes says, who cuts your hair? It's extremely long right now. I actually need to get a haircut. But this lady that works at the South Point barbershop, her name's Valerie. She has the unfortunate job of trying to make my hair look okay. And I've never had good hair, unfortunately. And it doesn't help that, you know, got the little receding hairline now. Doesn't make anything better. Plus, I don't get a lot of sleep, so hair quality isn't the best with a lot of, you know, lack of sleep, just late nights, and then having kids in the house, them being on their own schedules, kind of waking up around 6 a.m. each day. Not a super healthy lifestyle, but that's kind of how it goes with poker. I've been trying to do a little bit better. MD says, what's your total poker earnings, Brad? Also, how long were you non-profitable when you started? Love your vids, by the way. Hold on 1 second. I'll get to that in a second. We got a $10 donation from, I don't know, just changing my name. Brad, for a casual poker player like myself, are there any books or materials you recommend? Yes. I think starting out, probably get The Course by Ed Miller. That's a good book for everybody who plays anything between 1-2 and 5-10. There's actually sections for beating like 1-2 and 1-3. Then you read that section, you get to the 2-5 section, and then you get to the 5-10 session. Honeydew Drew 07, $10 Canadian. Hey Brad, shout out, been watching your videos on our Field X when I have some downtime. Haha, thanks man. I appreciate both those donations. That's awesome, guys. You know, I don't feel like, oh wow, another one from $5 from Scott C. Do you have a meetup game in Dallas anytime soon? Nothing planned at the moment, but that could, yeah, I mean, usually when I go to Texas, I'm just going to Austin these days, but maybe we'll get into the Dallas scene eventually. All right, we've got Ace King offsuit on the button. Good time to get Ace King offsuit. Let's see, we got one. Typically, how far are your vlogs behind real life? I'm just gonna call this one in position here. Got another playable hand, Ace of Diamonds. Ew. I mean, this should be better for our 3-bet calling range, and it is for his 3-bet range. We do have top pair on this other one as well. I'm just gonna go ahead and bet 1/3 pot here. Typically, there's a lot going on for cash game streams, trying to play two tables. All right, we got that one through. Now we'll go to the other game. Just gonna try to check call once again. This pot's getting pretty big. All right, seeing that check back was phenomenal. Maybe we can get called by nines or eights here. Maybe just ace high if he thinks that we're bluffing. Could get called on the lighter side. I'm kind of hoping for a call. I feel like our 10 is best here. What the fuck is this guy pretending to have? He's saying that he has pocket sevens? We need the extra 10 seconds here, guys. Ooh. I think maybe he just hit, I feel like he would have barreled with, like, the ace of clubs or king of clubs. What the fuck? He just has pocket sevens, I guess? This doesn't make a lot of sense. Alright, I'm gonna fold and just see what he has here. King six, yeah, that didn't make any sense. Damn it. Frustrating. Doesn't make sense when he checks back turn and then raises me on the river, unless he has like exactly pocket sevens or it was, I had like, anyway, that's an annoying one. Could have had, and then he hit and runs. What a bitch, you know? I don't want to have to call anybody that. I actually immediately regret saying that, but yeah. The jiggities, guys. Four-handed jiggities. Let's go. Come on, pot bet cat. Fight for this pot, buddy. It's not fighting for it. Jordan Mason said, how do you handle the days when you don't feel your best but still end up playing? Oftentimes when I don't feel my best, I end up losing. That is tough. I mean, honestly, a lot of the times it's just better to not play. I'm not 100% feeling my best right now. There's just a lot of things going on. Getting ready for the WPT World Championship. We've got our premier meetup game tomorrow. Phil Ivey's going to be there. And I'm actually going to exit out of this game. Phil Ivey's going to be there. We got a special guest. I don't think it's been officially announced yet, so I can't exactly say who it's going to be, but another legend of the game. All right, we're looking for a different game. We exited out of that previous one. We're going to play a little bit higher, guys. We got to make sure that I get this set up over here. But yeah, we're going to play the equivalent of kind of a, I guess it's kind of a bigger 5-10 or small 10-20 game. Oh, this is a new cool band that I've been introduced to called PD, I believe. We're going to be 3-betting this ace-5 suited, likely. But yeah, in this other game over here, we bought in for 10,000 RMB. It's equivalent of, I believe, 1,400. 6,000 over here is somewhere around 850 or so. You know what? I'm just going to go ahead and check this, actually. Because sometimes it comes up all spades, you know? And that's not good when you have hearts. I just didn't think a raise would get through like four players. I'd have to make it massive, and there's always a chance this person is gonna have like some huge hand that he limped in with, even though we have removal to pocket aces, but Ryan Max says, which has been more profitable, YouTube or poker? And that is pretty close. Probably poker throughout my entire life. I mean, last year I just crushed it. Last year I had my best year ever in poker. I won about $325,000 or $350,000 with about $250,000 of that being my money. The rest of the profit went to backers. This year, I got smoked in poker to start out the year. I've been doing really, really well from like March on, but I did get smoked in February, losing $300,000 over the course of a week playing absurdly big games at the lodge, like, you know, basically, you know, 200, 400, 800, and just 300,000 wasn't really that much. Jungleman and Ben Lamb, they both lost several hundred thousand, maybe even closer to $500,000 each. So I'm in pretty good company losing that much over there. Ran bad, caused me to play bad. But then I had a six-figure score. I won 125,000 and had 100% of myself. During that six-figure score for the WPT, I had my biggest... I had a bunch of my biggest cash game wins after that as well. I won 68,000 in one session. Had about, I think I only had 40% of myself in that one, but it was still a nice chunk. I only had about, 200,000 of that 300,000 loss was mine personally this year in February. So the fact that I got out of the hole and got $200,000 back before June was maybe my biggest accomplishment in poker, or at least something that I'm the most proud of, since I thought it literally might take me years to get 200,000 back. Anyway, Rory O'Day, $10 for the swear jar. Rory is someone that I grew up with in Sonoma County. We played soccer together. His dad was my soccer coach, so good to see him in the chat. Almost 1,200 people watching right now. Fucking awesome, guys. Need to put some more money in the swear jar, I guess. So, TLKZMM says the depth of depravity to be up streaming playing in Chinese yuan. There are actual options to play in US currency, but they only have it available in small stakes at the moment. So this is actually just a fold from this position. Probably would have raised it smaller as well from under the gun, but it's tough to play kind of as sharply as I normally would when I'm trying to play two games online and keep up with the chat. But honestly, the chat is more fun for me, so so that's kind of gonna be my priority. Let's see, why not just bet a third pot here? Maybe we can take it down. If not, we can get out of there, and we do take it down, so that's good. Rails says, hope to see you at the Wynn next week, Brad. Good luck to everyone. I'm gonna be firing a ton at the Wynn, and we're kicking things off. It's actually already started, but with the $600 event. But the meetup game is tomorrow, starts at 9 a.m., so it's bright and early. I'll be there at 8:30. I would recommend that people get there early if they can, since just a lot going on, like right at 9 a.m., and if you can show up a bit before the official start time, that helps things run a bit more smoothly. Josh Gavin says, do you play any other instruments besides guitar? I had a drum set at one time, but I never played it well. I think the drums are just the most fun instrument to play. I think using your whole body to play an instrument is pretty cool. All right, let's see. Without giving away your income, how do taxes work as a professional poker player? So I am still technically a CPA, although I'm inactive. I just report taxes as honestly as I can because I don't want any trouble with the IRS, and I don't want my CPA license to be revoked. But I just keep track of my winnings and report those. You know, I have income from a bunch of other sources as well, from WPT, obviously, from YouTube, from other affiliate sites that I have partnerships with, Upswing, PokerCoaching.com. So it's kind of a nightmare to get everything organized for tax season, to be honest, since I do have multiple streams of revenue. When we were doing meetup games more, especially when Andrew and I were doing them outside of WPT, we would get compensated from different casinos. So we'd have, 1099s from different properties as well sometimes. So I think at the high point, it probably had like 10 different 1099s when I was doing my taxes, which is almost the easiest part. When you have 1099s and they tell you exactly how much they gave you for the year, not every company does that. So I have to like go back through different accounts and manually figure out how much I was paid. But that's not super fun. Evan Grenier says, how is your memory so good? I don't know. I just luckily was pretty fortunate to have a good memory. NorCal Poker says, Sonoma County, NorCal represent. Yeah, I was just out there. I was just back for Thanksgiving. I was there for 10 days. Played a high-stakes session at Grayton, so that's going to come out in a couple weeks. There was a question earlier from someone asking how far behind are vlogs from my life typically? And that was a good question. Generally, it's a couple weeks, 3 to 4 weeks or so. But since I've been, here we go, finally got a good playable hand here. Right now is the biggest gap because we were making two vlogs a week, but just releasing one a week. So I have 8 in the pipeline, and I guess it's still from like 4 weeks ago, the one that's gonna come out tomorrow morning. But when we start releasing 2 a week, we'll get all caught up. Oh, there we go. We got the old top pair. Really wanted this guy to fold. I'm just going to go ahead and check call this. We're not beating ace-7, ace-3, ace-5. Obviously not beating ace-jack, ace-queen. Check back is good until we see the heart. I'm going to put out a blocker bet. If we get raised, I can pretty comfortably fold here. Because sometimes we're going to be up against this set. But I feel like if we checked, he would have bet more. This way we get to showdown for a little bit cheaper. Frustrating to get 2 outed in that spot. But I guess he probably had... probably had a backdoor straight draw as well. Did he have a straight draw on the... on... the turn there? Do you have a gutter? We'll call one time. Oh shit. Made kind of a mistake here. I called in this situation. Didn't realize there was a player behind me. Like I said, tough to kind of play your best in these situations. Let's see if... oh, shit. Wow, he just turned quads on us. Well, a lot of the time when they bet pot, it's going to be nothing or something extremely good. And this time we ran into something extremely good. Not fun. Happy to play a limp pot in this situation. Top pair. I like it. Oh yeah, I forgot. That game's much bigger over there. So that wasn't really that big of a bet. It's 5 big blinds. We'll just... you know what? We'll bet it. Just clear out some of this equity. Don't... fuck this guy. He just raises when there's a bunch of other people in the hand. We're gonna fold. I'm gonna... everybody has this ability to reveal hands if they pay extra for it. Kinda wanted to see. He had top and bottom pair. Didn't seem like a spot where he'd be doing that light, so doesn't really matter. Andrew T says, do you do your own taxes since you're a CPA? I don't. I want nothing to do with taxes. I was in corporate audit, so I dealt with corporations and they're auditing their financial statements. But never dealt with individual taxes other than when I was studying for the CPA exams and taking classes for them. But not very well versed in all the tax loopholes or anything. Let's see. Kyle Chinchetta says, should I report my club GG rake? I'm assuming you have your own club and you're making money from that. I would report it, especially because that's technically not legal to be running your own club on there. And I feel like you're more likely to get in trouble if you're not reporting your income from it. I feel like if you do report your income from it, government's not really going to come after you, but this isn't legal advice. I try to stay away from the online clubs, to be honest. But yeah. Christopher Culier said, how tall is the lanky white guy? I'm 6'3". We're doing a bomb pot over here. Jack six. This is a tricky situation, eight-handed. We have top pair in position at least, but when you're dealing with seven other opponents, when everybody's range is by definition uncapped because they all have random cards. I mean, think of all the combinations that we're losing to. The nuts, obviously, king, queen, queen, eight, eight, seven, sets, jack 10, jack 9, 10, 9. It's just really not a great situation. So I'm actually going to just fold this. We don't have any backup plan if our pair is no good. I mean, he's betting half pot. This is the important one that we want to win on. So we exited out of that other game. This one is 25, 50, 100. So it's about, it is like a 10-20 game, really. It is like the third blind is basically like $14. And so there's like 25 in the pot or more with the ante. Probably closer to, yeah, over 30-ish. Not. Math is hard. How much is in the pot to start this thing? What is 175 times 0.14? Yeah, 2450 in the pot to start things out. All right, top pair. Just try and get to showdown. Try to get to showdown cheaply. Don't, one third pot, don't mind seeing that. Definitely gonna call. Five of clubs is a good innocuous card for us. Love seeing the check back there. We're just gonna go ahead and bet small here. Kind of a blocker bet. If he has a better ace than us, he's gonna call and we're gonna get to showdown. But like if he raises here, he's gotta have like just king 10. Like what the fuck is this guy pretending to have? Like king 10, 10, 8. I just don't, this is a very similar situation. Oh shit, am I not even, no. Damn it, I wasn't even on the right one, fuck. Wow. Folded in this other situation, but he did have king 10. How do I go back to hands? Yeah, so he had a king 10 here. I bet one third pot on the river with... I had ace 7 of clubs, and he raised me big, and time ran out, and I folded. All right. I gotta focus, guys. Gotta focus here. Two-thirds pot. I feel very, very good about this flop. I want to keep him in there with hands that are worse. We pick up the flush draw. We're just going to go ahead and we'll bet one-third pot. Wouldn't mind getting a call. Forty-seven Indigo says you still play on Poker Bros. I haven't played on Poker Bros in years. PP Burr says, do you consider getting a rub and tug as cheating? Yes, I do. Not afraid to tackle the controversial topics here, guys. Ranjit Singh says, how much are you playing for? This game, we've got about 800 in front of us. On this other side, game two, we've got about 1,000 in front of us. So, pretty big game over here. I might add on for a little more. This is my account balance, not counting what I have. At the tables, Just add a little bit more here. Whoops. Guess you can't add on for less than 5K. I'll just wait for a little bit. But yeah, if you want to come play with me on Global, sign up using that bonus code Brad. That'll get you deposit match bonus of 1,200. Two guys got in for with Ace 10 over here. Interesting. We are gonna be three betting this one. Need to bet a little bit more. Time's running out. Got the fold, got the win. Mikkel Pedersen says, Brad, why are you playing for that small amount? This is a pretty big amount of money, especially online. The level, like when you're playing online, especially multi-tabling, and especially when you're kind of streaming and stuff, this player's pretty good. I'm actually gonna do something. I'm actually just gonna call this one. See a flop. Usually I would just three bet it, but yeah, when you're playing online, players are better. I know how to fold as a good player. Seen him at the tables quite a bit. Let's flop a set. Damn it, that's not good. This is a particularly bad board for us because we can get counterfeited with a 10 and then we end up with 8 high. But to third of a pot, we're gonna see one off. This ace is always going to be better for his range, so it's not very good for us. And he's going to be betting at a high frequency when this ace comes off, knowing that it's going to put me in a tough spot. And he could be bluffing because he's going to have a wide range with a lot of hands that he's going to play on the button. So I would expect him to be bluffing pretty regularly here. And wow, flopped a full house. So that's not great. Tough to win when you're up against full houses. And I'm glad you didn't 3-bet there. Disaster. But we are going to 3-bet here. So yeah, guys, we're going to just get it in. Big pot. Have him dead. Almost dead. Now I just jinxed myself for sure. Jack is for sure coming. No, it's not. All right. We just get this person doing something insane. That happens quite a bit on this site. This is the softest online site that I've ever played. There are some good players on here, but you just see people going nuts in certain spots when they really don't have to. Like, he just 4-bet ripped it for like 50 big blinds or something, I think. Blue Cheese says, when are you gonna run a fan meetup game in Montreal? Would be pretty cool. Hate to tell you this, Blue Cheese, but we were there at the end of October. Me, Rampage, and Andrew, we did a meetup game with WPT Global at Playground. I believe the meetup game was it was like October 25th or something, sometime around then, 23rd. Had a blast. And so that video is going to come out Monday. I've got a new vlog coming out tomorrow. Be sure to watch that one. And if you can watch it as soon as it comes out, 10 a.m. Friday. It's a different day than I normally put out videos, but we're doing 2 a week in December. Maybe 3 a week some weeks. And that is thanks to WPT Global for, you know, hiring an editor so we can put out more content. And so everybody is kind of just benefiting with that deal, which is pretty awesome. You guys getting more content. I'm able to play more. So very, very happy about that setup. Able to stream more. I'm not really able to stream that much when I'm kind of putting out my own content. It just takes so much effort to play a session for, you know, 6 to 8 hours, go home, write the script. Like, writing the scripts will be often you know, 11 or 12 pages single spaced. So I have to write out those. It's like writing a college thesis every week. And then doing all the editing that goes along with it, picking the music, shooting the intros and outros, doing all the graphics, and then putting it all together, watching it through, creating titles and thumbnails. Thumbnails and titles don't take that much time, but you know, every little thing ends up being time consuming. Hit ace king offsuit here, ended up just taking it down preflop. We got queen jack suited here. This is a limp, this is a raise. I'll go ahead and call here, see a flop, not ideal. Daniel B, $5 Canadian. Hi, Brad. When I signed up for WPT a few weeks ago through deposit code, I just won my first tourney today. Thanks for streaming on YouTube. That's awesome, man. I love hearing that. I'm going to bet 33% here. If we can take this down with queen high, that is really, really good. He's probably not going to have eights. I mean, he could have eights, but not super often. He's going to have... This is great for our range. Not only do we pick up the flush draw, but he's not going to have like sevens, sixes, eight, seven. Like, look at what he has here. Ace, queen. So he has us pretty crushed, but just with the range advantage, we're able to really take advantage of the situation. And steal the win without having to make a flush. So that's always nice. So we're actually crushing here. We're up 8,000 won after that all-in. I think won is synonymous with renminbi. So I typically call it renminbi since people confuse won with yen. Mixing poker in the chat. Is this the Brad Owen I stumbled upon, he says? It is, Mixin. Good to see you in the chat. Mixin is... a barbecue master, lives in Austin, Texas. I think I just saw on social media that he may have just landed in Vegas. I saw him, you can check out his Instagram account. I think it's called Mixin' Poker. But yeah, he took a picture of slot machines at the airport and said something along the lines of, when you see the slot machines, you know what airport you're in. And that's for sure true. Ridge Runner says, do you have pants on? I do, but I might take them off later if this stream gets wild. Mikkel Pedersen, when do you come to Denmark? Copenhagen Casino, I'd love to see you here. That sounds awesome. Maybe I'll try to make it work down there. I've never been to Denmark. Been to Norway, been to... a lot of other places in Europe, Germany, France, Ireland, England, Finland for a layover in Helsinki, Spain. But yeah, I love traveling and going to as many countries as I can. Frank Rizzo, do you have any nicknames? I'm voting for Browens, hyphenated. I'm gonna vote against that. Strong vote against that. But yeah, we do have a nickname, the Giraffe. And then I don't know, a couple other ones people have probably given me. None of them have really stuck all that much. But yeah, the Giraffe is the oldest nickname, probably kind of my favorite one because it was given to me by this guy who is called, his name's Rocco at Red Rock, and he used to play there every day. He was like the Red Rock Poker Room grandfather, pretty much. And just really love that guy. Ace queen offsuit, we're gonna be three betting this from the small blind. Might even have to get it all in against the small blind if he just does something wild with like a big four bet here. And we got a playable hand on the other table as well. So we got a call there. Not even sure what the action is here. I guess this guy posted Moses Jong. Fuck. All right, we're gonna have to fold the ace jack. We do flop top pair in this situation. He would have bet with, I'm going to bet small here. He would have 4-bet with ace-king, so really not concerned about being beat by a better kicker. We need to try to line this up for a river shove. So if I bet here, it'll line us up for like a 2/3 pot shove. Let's see what he had. Probably a pocket pair between aces. Oh, king-queen suited. Reasonable, I suppose. Peels one off. Yeah, makes sense. No pocket pair. $5 from Greg Baso. He's always in the chat donating. I appreciate that. He says, I'm at Resorts World next week. You playing at Wynn or someplace? Because I want some Bradley dollars. I'll be playing at the Wynn a ton. I'm firing a ton of tournaments. Probably firing between $60,000 and $100,000 worth of tournaments this month. Playing a 25K. Playing 25K buy-in. My first ever live 25K buy-in. So really, really excited about that. Playing at least one 10K. I'll play that 10K $40 million guarantee. That's the biggest and my most favorite tournament of the year for WPT. It's the WPT World Championship $40 million guarantee. I'll hopefully just have to fire one bullet in that, but I'll fire two if I need to. Then there's some other 10Ks that I might be playing as well. At least one other. And there's some 1100s, the Prime Championship. That's an $1,100, $5 million guarantee, which is ridiculous. Bradley J74 says, is this Chinese currency? So you have about 10 US dollars. Trying to be a smart ass, but he's incredibly wrong. 18,000 renminbi. Let's see what that is. It is Chinese currency, but that's 2,500 US. So this is a fairly sizable game over here. And then at this other table, we've got close to, yeah, so we have almost 18,000 here, and then here we have close to about 800. So this game is smaller, but it's still like the size of a 2-5 game. And when you're playing online, you're typically playing against better opponents. Not necessarily true on WPT Global. There are some big whales that play massively. You guys saw when we got it in with Ace King versus Queen 10 suited for a pile. And really, if you can just pick people off like that and not blast away yourself, you can make a ton of money. Z says, no, I'm not trolling. Stop promoting online poker. I mean, I don't know why promoting online poker is bad. Particularly, like, I'm showing you guys how I play every hand, which is cool compared to vlogs, where you guys just see the big hands that I play that are cherry-picked because they're big pots or just interesting situations. I think this is really cool, and this kind of shows how an overall strategy comes together when you see the decisions I'm making pre-flop, the hands that I'm folding. Oftentimes, hands I fold post-flop don't make the vlog either, just simply because if I call a 3-bet pre-flop with pocket fives, for instance, and the flop comes like ace-queen-nine and someone c-bets, I'm just folding, and that's not really very fun to make a video of. But I still think it's kind of important to get an idea for those kinds of situations. Mr. Nihilus says, do you drink on stream? If so, say yes and crack open a beer exactly 3 minutes later. I'll be ready with mine. Don't feel like drinking right now. It's noon in Las Vegas. And I haven't eaten anything yet. So pretty content to just chill. Did have a kombucha with some alcohol in it. There's a little bit of alcohol, I think, in like pretty much every kombucha. Little bit of Modest Mouse. Throwback to high school. This is one of my favorite songs by them. It's like, this is probably, this has to be the biggest song that they've ever had in terms of mainstream success. But just a really, really cool song. It was kind of an interesting video. I just love how Modest Mouse has a very unique sound. One of my favorite bands. Component says, do you have to VPN to play on global? I'm whitelisted as a WPT global ambassador, so let's see a flop here. So I'm not VPNing, but as long as I don't deposit or withdraw from inside the United States, our legal team has said that we're not actually breaking any laws. So I'm able to do that. They made an exception for me to show off the site. But if other people in the US unfortunately can't play on WPT Global at the moment. Hopefully that'll change at some point. As soon as legislation gets their act together. So this is the big game over here. Typically you want to see the Asian screen names, because these other guys, they're just coming from, you know, other European countries where they've had online poker for a while. They tend to be good players. Some of the Asian players are really good as well, but a lot of them tend to not be professionals, just because there are just so many non-pros on the site coming from Asia. And this is a fairly big game. Mr. Buberick says, I read that WPT is super strict towards VPN as well, and it's easy to get banned and warned. Yeah, I mean, honestly, I wouldn't recommend it. WPT Global is trying to do everything as above board as possible so that when things do open up in the United States, they can get in there. This isn't like a fake, no, don't use a VPN. This is like an actual don't use a VPN if you're from the US. Because I don't want to see you guys get banned. Don't want to see any money get confiscated or anything like that. All right, Greg Beso, $5. My time there unfortunately doesn't coincide with the WPT tournament series. By the way, my name is pronounced similar to best, so Beso. All right, cool, man. Well, thanks again for the donation. So WPT stuff, tournament series is going on all of December. So if you're here, I think you said next week, that's still kind of right in the midst of it. So still going to be a ton of action. A lot of the best players in the world are going to be walking through the halls at the Wynn, which is always cool. And, just a fun, exciting kind of atmosphere. So yeah. Definitely check out the Wynn. You'll probably see me there if you're around, if anyone's come to Vegas. Darren Collins, you think we will ever get back to the glory days of US online poker? I love playing on Full Tilt, but now I can't play anything from Utah. I think if it's ever opened up in the US, right now it's state by state, and some new state just recently passed an online legalization. I forget what state it is. It's like Vermont or Virginia or something. So that was encouraging. I think it'll happen eventually, but it might take like 10 years, which is too bad. Washington State is like vehemently against it, and that's unfortunate. David Manlio says, afternoon, you haven't eaten anything yet? Emoji. Maybe get something to eat. Might improve your decision-making abilities. Yeah, it definitely always helps. Usually if I'm going to play a long session, definitely prefer to eat first. But I don't think it's going to be too much of a difference. Usually I just kind of eat like two big meals a day. Potato says, how do I become a backer for you? Honestly, I always try to avoid staking deals almost as much as possible, particularly with viewers. I mean, getting backed is just, there's a couple ways to view it. Kind of the way that I can't help but view it is, if I lose money, I feel bad, like I let down people who invested in me. And then if I win, means I don't keep 100% of what I won. So it's not particularly fun to be involved in backing deals. Just sorting out all the money and everything like that. And I just try to play games where I have an edge in. So I want as much of my action as I can have, as long as I can afford it. I do think it's fun to give viewers a sweat, but it also like makes me stress out a little bit more thinking about that. David Kopic, $4.99. I was excited about tomorrow's mug and the WPT giveaways, but a 9 a.m. start is no bueno for Las Vegas high school teacher. Good luck in the tourney. David, yes, that is brutal. 9 a.m., honestly, 9 a.m. mug start is not good for me either. Wish it was later in the day, but I appreciate the donation. But yeah, Wynn is just so busy in general that that's kind of the only time we can do it. We've got two big hands here, King Jack suited and pocket tens. We're gonna go ahead and bet with the tens first, and then we're just gonna flat the pocket kings in this bigger game. Let's see what kind of flops we get. Of course, the worst one possible, I'm gonna just bet tiny here, because that's gonna be pretty effective when we're dealing with the hands that we beat and we get called, which isn't ideal. But, you know, over here we've got bottom pair and a gutter. How to fold could have smaller pocket pairs that we're beating. I am gonna call on this pocket tens one time just because I'm not fully buying that he has us beat. Do we get check raised? Yeah, I mean, lost to ace deuce. Got check raised. We have blockers to the nuts though. So that's the only thing that I'm kind of excited to, could he be turning my tens into a bluff? We'll just fold. We'll just wait for a better spot. See what he has here. 9-10, yeah. Not super surprised to see him turn a hand like that into a bluff, but that information is good to know, like that he's check raising with that. He had removal to the nuts, and since I didn't 3-bet, I'm not gonna have sets of aces, queens, and jacks. And I won't have ace queen very often, so he's banking on my range not having really a lot of like the second through 10th best hands in there, but I obviously will have, you know, some king 10 type of hands. Soulless PvP says, I'm going to be at the mug tomorrow. I just got here, so sorry if someone already asked. Could you talk about it a little and what you're going to expect? Yeah, so it's going to be awesome. We're playing 1-3 and 2-5. We're giving away one seat worth $10,400 to the WPT World Championship tomorrow. There's going to be different promos and ways to win raffle tickets. And then at the end, there's going to be a drawing for that seat. And then I think 4 or 5 seats to the $1,100 prime event. It's a $5 million guarantee. So it's a pretty cool way to potentially win a 10K seat and some $1,100 ones. But we're gonna probably have like 25 tables going. Phil Ivey's gonna be there, Jesse Sylvia, Ashley Sleeth. By now it's probably been announced that we're gonna have a very special guest. Gus Hansen is gonna be there tomorrow as well, which is very, very cool. That was supposed to be announced publicly today, but hasn't been announced previously to that. Let's just flop a set one time. And Yeah, I think Rampage is going to be there for a little while. Mariano, just a bunch of vloggers. I'm not going to try to bluff this one. Just too tough to get through two players when they could have, they could have connected with this board. Greg Besso, $5 again. Love to see my home state of Vermont pass a casino bill, but for now I'll settle playing at Mohegan Sun, Connecticut, and Encore Boston. This guy just fold? Whatever. We'll just try to see if sixes are best. Nope, they're not. And Encore Boston Harbor. Yeah, I was just in Boston not that long ago. Had a good trip to Boston. Loved it. We got two pair on this side. Top two pair in a limped pot. I am going to have to bet this. Got the call, got a very safe turn card. Come on, call, dude, call. Joey Mullis says, how much is the stack in the thumbnail? That one's a little over 30K. That was from when I played table one at Aria. Stefano Barbiero says, how do you think the Encore in Boston played in comparison to the Wynn and other establishments you played at in Vegas? Hope you come back soon. I just, Vegas is just the toughest place to play poker, so everywhere else is better. I mean, with the exception of, you know, places in Europe and stuff. Some places in Europe are really tough. But in the US, Vegas is by far the toughest. Basically, what happened was, a long time ago, there weren't that many places you could play poker outside of Vegas. Certainly no places that were like super exciting to play. So everybody moved to Vegas. There were always a ton of games. There were actually a ton more poker rooms when I first moved out in 2012 and when a lot of other pros moved out. But with now that there are casinos kind of all over the U.S., there's a bunch in Florida, the Hard Rock ones, there's Encore Boston, there's MGM National Harbor, Maryland Live. Kind of all those poker rooms that are big and they're in fancy, nice casinos, people don't need to come to Vegas as much to play poker. And I think that hurts the poker ecosystem in Las Vegas. So you just end up being left with like a lot of poker pros that play for a living that moved out a long time ago. And then, you know, a couple locals that are recreational players as well. Pretty big cooler on this side. They chop it. They could chop it, though. And then, yeah, just kind of waiting for, like, conventions to come into town or for big tournament series to come into town. And hopefully you end up getting seated at a good table and you know, end up winning. Ids Beaker has a good question. It says, when you discuss ranges and possibilities, are you assuming that all opponents are using the same playing theories? Yes. If you don't have any baseline to go off of, you can't. It's really, really tough to make good decisions. So you go from a baseline, you kind of assume everybody's playing as close to theoretically sound as possible, but that's obviously not the case. Like Queen-8 suited might be, it's probably like really, really close to being a raise in this situation. And it may be, and shit, I just didn't have the right game up, but yeah, I folded Queen-8 suited from under the gun here. So yeah, it may be theoretically correct with the ante situation to play queen eight suited from under the gun when it's seven handed. Pom pom with ace king. That's not the time you want to get ace king. But anyway, and then as you see people deviating from things that they should be doing or what I think they should be doing, then I adjust my strategy to capitalize on that. If you just don't have the baseline, and if you're not assuming that they're playing more theoretically sound ranges, then, and you don't know anything else about them, then you're just flying blind, and that you can't really make any good decisions that way. If you're just like, well, you could have seven deuce offsuit here, so I need to be worried about that. But yeah. How was your time at Best Bet Jacksonville? It was good. Meetup game was good. I lost 15K in the tournament, so that poker profitability wise, it was awful. Ran terrible in the 5K buy-in, which I was really looking forward to. The first hand I sat down, I 3-bet ace king of spades. The flop came queen 8-6 all spades, so we flopped the nuts in position. I got check raised. I just flat to let the guy blast off. Turn pairs the six. He bets big. I just call because I'm worried he could have me. I could be drawing dead. River pairs the queen. So it's ends up being queen 8-6, six queen. He bets like kind of medium size amount, and then I just have to fold. That was just a super brutal way to start the 5K. So I lose half my stack. Kind of grind it back up to about starting stack. And then stack dwindles again. And then I get it in with ace king offsuit versus pocket eights. I lose that flip. I rebuy. One or two hands into the rebuy, it might have been the first hand. I cold 4-bet ace king offsuit from the small blind. The button calls with ace queen offsuit, and then river's a queen. So it was like nearly back-to-back hands. I lose in a pretty brutal way. I lose 10K. So that was unfortunate. Then I bought in for a third time and bluffed off like half my stack. Like blind, I didn't have a ton of big blinds, but I bluffed in the spot that I thought was good, but it ended up not being that great when I looked back at it. And then I got it in with a open-ended straight draw and one over with King 10 on like a Queen Jack six board against Queen 8 suited, and the guy turned trips and ended up losing that one as well. So yeah, not great poker-wise. Brian Cano says, how does new money enter the pro table economy? We do have trips here. New money comes in through the recreational players that have other jobs, you know? Guys that are, got called by Ace High, nice. The guys that are, especially the really wealthy guys, like, they want to play high stakes a lot of the time, which is awesome. So it's interesting how the high stakes games in Vegas generally consist of some of the best cash game players in the world, perhaps the best cash game players in the world. And then there'll be like 7-8 of those types. And then there'll be like one mega whale who can't beat 1-3, but has, you know, a good amount of money. And, is willing to potentially blast off. And so it's different than like a 2-5 or 5-10 environment where you really want to be kind of one of the top two or three table players at the table. Like you can be the second worst player at the table in those high stakes games and you're going to be put in a lot of uncomfortable spots. But if you can just stack you know, the multi-millionaire whale once, then you can kind of just make up for it, especially if it's like, just, you know, you can play like just massive all-ins that are between $50,000 and $100,000 or more. If you win one of those a week, you could potentially still make a good living and potentially make more than you would in a 5-10 game, where your edge is bigger. All right, it's 40 below. $10 donation from him. Love your content, learned a lot from it. So far, only played for fun. If I were in Vegas, any recommendations on places to try for my first cash games? Maybe one, two. I would go to Caesars. I think, you know, it's right in the middle of the strip. It's a fun property to be at. They always have a ton of 1-2 games. If you go to Aria, Bellagio, and Wynn, I believe the smallest games they have are 1-3. And so those buy-ins are typically a little bit bigger. And I just think, yeah, I think Caesars on the strip has kind of the most fun 1-2 game if you're coming in from out of town. Whoops. Let's win a big pot. We haven't won any big pots in a little while. 1,500 people watching. I appreciate it, guys. Been doing this for over an hour. Not sure how much longer we're going to be doing this for. Maybe a little while. It's been fun hanging out. I don't want to get another big win on this stream. Maybe we can flop a set here. Kind of a... Damn, this guy really just doesn't have much. This guy cold calls. We have him. He's got more chips. Let's just set mine one time. And we don't hit the set. Bad flop when he gets 3-bet by this guy as well. He's going to have kings, queens, aces, ace, king. All hands that we won't have when we don't 4-bet. Someone asked, Justin C. says, Brad up for 2023. I am up for 2023. Started out the year in a massive hole due to just getting absolutely torched in some live stream games at the lodge. Three straight sessions of streamed games. I lost 300,000, 200,000 of it being my own money. But if you look at my Hendon mob, did pretty well in some tournaments right after that, including a six-figure score with WPT, which is awesome, and another 30K score in Cambodia. Another final table right after the WPT one, actually online for WSOP in a bracelet event. So I got fourth in a WPT event out of 300 entries, and then I got sixth out of like 2,400 entries in a WSOP $400 online event. So it was a cool 2 weeks. And then I've done really well in cash games since February on the Lodge live stream. I think I've won, well, I did have one loss where I lost like 11K, I think, 8K or 11K or something. But I won 68K, I won 19K, I think 12K. And so yeah, I've been doing really, really well there. Since then, and just done well in cash in general since then. I haven't been doing as well in tournaments though, so hopefully that'll change for the WPT series this December, or like this in a couple days. Actually, it's already started, but I've just got some huge. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna bet small here, and then we're gonna bet big on the turn with our gutter. If he calls, we're just gonna blast turn. He's not really going to have many deuces in his range. He's got to make some tough decisions with like a queen in his hand, which I think is likely what he had. Yeah, queen 10 suited. So once again, that reveal hands feature is not something that I use that often. It's something that's available to everybody. If you pay a little bit extra, you can see what people were holding after the hand, Everybody has access to it. I do it more often during a stream so that you guys can see the hands, and it's just way, way more fun when we know what people actually have. So that was a cool hand because basically the plan came together exactly like we drew it up. Oh shit, I didn't even have it on. God damn it, that's super annoying. Sorry guys, a lot going on. Here's what happened in this one. I raised preflop. Straddler called, I bet with our gutter and backdoor straight draw. Straddler called, deuce comes out, he checks. I bet big, like 80% pot. He has to fold. We see what he has, and he has queen 10 suited, so got him to fold the best hand, and that was just a nice hand. Fuck. I accidentally just clicked out of it. I am not doing well trying to do so many things at once, but I accidentally clicked out of that game, so I'll try to get back into it. Hold on. But we are going to play this one first. Maybe I can get back in right away. All right, so we are in a different 25, 50, 100 game now, I believe. Maybe it's better. Do you have top pair here? He bets it. We're going to be calling. Oh, wow. Turn two pair. Nice. I like this. So very likely we've got the best hand. Hopefully he bets big. He bets half pot. We're just going to go ahead and raise it up. Maybe we can get it all in a top two pair here. Maybe he's going to have some kind of combo draw or an over pair that he's going to want to get it all in with. He's calling for extra time. Let's go. Here's the other game. For a sec. Not a great river card. It could be up against King 10, King 9. I mean, it's great if he has something like... Two pair might just be too good in this spot. He might have Queen Jack here. He might just be getting in very bad. But if he has a King of any sort, King Jack, King Queen, King X of Diamonds, he might be willing to call. I just think that we're bluffing with a missed Diamond draw or like 8-7 or Jack 8 or something. Jack 8 suited. He's thinking about it. So he probably has one pair. And I think that we've got the best hand. So I'm liking this shove more and more. Feeling pretty good about it. Call it, dude. People bluff all the time on this site. You know it. I know it. And I mean, this is a pretty fun thin shove. Damn it. Let's see what he had. I feel like he had a king. Yeah, King Jack. So he had the exact hand I was kind of targeting. He got away from it, which is good for him. But if I knew exactly what he had, I probably would have done the same thing. Got a bomb pot over here. Don't make the set. So we're in for 10,000 over here. That's the equivalent of 1,400. We left two other games that we were up on earlier in this stream. If you haven't been following along, I'm up several thousand so far. So I've got 1,400 on this table. We got 2,200 all together. So since the stream started, I think I'm up about like 600 to 800. And then overall today, I'm up about 3,000 or 2,800 or something. It's pretty sweet. Especially just playing about an hour. So yeah, if you guys want to join me on the site and you're in a country where you're able to play it, sign up using that bonus code Brad. That'll get you a deposit match bonus of up to $1,200, which is awesome. There's just tons of value just by signing up and depositing on the site. And the games are the softest that they that I've ever seen, basically, for an online site. Typically, online is going to be tougher than live in general, but that's just not the case while the site is still new and there are a ton of people in the Asian countries that are playing that, you know, really haven't caught up to the rest of the world when it comes to playing. So we could have a big pot here. Guys, I think we are just going to have to this is a big sizing, but I think we're just going to have to get it in here. Hopefully we're up against Ace King or Jacks, but very likely could be Ace or Kings, and a lot of our profit would be gone, but we're always calling. Pocket aces, yeah. So, a lot of the profit's gonna be gone now. Don't even have the diamond flush draws live, so that is unfortunate. Sit back in. So, there goes 1,400 of our profit there. Hurts to lose that one. This is a pretty big game over here. It's equivalent of about 10-20. Wow, 1600 watching now. That is very, very cool. And guess what, guys? We've got the jiggities. Let's see here. This guy we've been battling with, we gotta go more than that. Been battling with him quite a bit. He might think that we just bluffed him with the old 10, when we had the 10-9 hand. Not ideal. We are going to check this one. We three bet him. He can have pocket eights, pocket threes, plenty of hands containing kings. We can't fold just yet, although this isn't really a comfortable spot. Hopefully he checks back turn. If he doesn't, if he keeps blasting, we're probably going to have to give up at this point just because our sack to pot ratio is 2-1. Don't really want to go broke with second pair in this particular spot, but not a great, yeah. All right, man, you could be bluffing with any number of hands, but we'll just let it go. We'll live to fight another day. 8-6, that is frustrating. Wow, he's coming after me. That's good to know, good to know. Time to add on here. Want to have this guy covered. Six suited calls a three bet. Arnold Vosloo. On the WPT side, terms and conditions, pretty much all the countries are excluded, so where can you play from? Almost all of the EU and Americas are excluded. You can play from pretty much every province in Canada. You can play in Ireland. There's kind of a lot of countries that you can play for in, but I mean, it is, there are plenty in the UK that are restricted or whatever. Pretty much the entire UK. But there are still quite a few countries that you can play. I don't have the list in front of me right now, but it is in the list of in the turn in the hold on, sorry guys. Terms of in the terms. Let's see here. Gotta get some momentum going, you know. That Queens versus Aces one was pretty brutal. That was like a 3K pot that we had lost. Josh says, how often does he not have aces or kings there? Didn't he 4-bet pre? I don't know if you saw the hand earlier when he got it in against queen 10 suited in a after that player 4-bet jammed. But it's often enough to make queens very, very profitable in that spot, on this site in particular. People are just getting it in pretty light. Sometimes you're going to run into it. When you have the third best hand and you run into the best one, it's a cooler. So you don't lose sleep over those ones, especially for 100 big blinds. Darren Dawson, Brad, do you play any video games? I used to play Halo a lot. I don't play any video games right now. It's just, there's so much poker that I'm playing. Why is this? Why is this eye thing coming on? I just play a lot of poker and spend pretty much as much time as I can playing or working on videos. So, what is this hand over here? It's a pretty big pot. That guy's not a good player. The Jiggities once more. Let's see if they can redeem themselves. And we see an overcard. So, ace high flops are better for my in position range. Although I won't have a lot of offsuit combos. Like, I won't have ace 9, ace 8 offsuit, ace 7, ace 6 offsuit. Whereas he might have some of those. So the ace 7, 6 isn't like super great for us, but it's not bad. Jesse Allen says, with that $1,200 deposit match, what stops anyone from doing the deposit and immediately cashing out for $2,400? Good question. You do have to play through the $1,200. So it gets released bit by bit the more you play on the site as a control to keep people from bankrupting the company. David Conaway. Hi, Brad. Is there a non-poker book that helped you with the most with the business aspect of your poker career? There's one called Treat Your Poker Like a Business. I know that's not exactly fair because it is technically a poker book, but it's not poker strategy. It's about all the ancillary stuff that goes with playing poker for a living. So bankroll management and a handful of other things. We're gonna have a lot of flush combos in our range, and we have removal to some of them. That's why I turned that hand into a bluff. Also have removal to Ace King as well. But let's see, I mean, I read, you know, a Warren Buffett book. I read like Rich Dad, Poor Dad, those kind of books. I think those are all beneficial. We are gonna raise this one up with the old Ace Jack offsuit. Don't wanna play a multi-way pot out of position against the button. Happy to just take that one down without making a pair. But yeah, if you guys are just joining, got a new vlog out tomorrow. We're doing two vlogs a week at least going forward for the month of December. We got the Jiggities again. So thanks to WPT Global for hooking it up with an editor for me. That's allowed me to be able to put multiple vlogs out per month in December and still play a full slate of tournaments. Guys, at some point, we're going to have to, let's just bet 2/3 here. It's not quite 2/3. It's a little over 50%. But yeah, we just keep having... do I need to turn jacks into a bluff? He's just going to have a queen a lot, or like some weak king, or diamonds, actually. He could have diamonds a lot here. But this is just so uncomfortable to have third pair. The fact he checked back is good. We're going to do a little blocker bet here. He's probably going to call with a queen, but... or a king. But yeah, at least we don't have to... Could have even gone smaller with that one. At least we don't have to like check call a bigger bet. Because if I checked, I'd feel very inclined to call. He might go half pot or more. So going less than a third is not bad in my opinion. I think I'm just going to take a free card here. Jiggities haven't been good for us. No right way to play them. Dream says, how's your work-life balance? It's not super great, to be honest. But, and that's partly, it's a lot of it is my choice, because I love doing the poker stuff, and I love creating the content and interacting with you guys, so... I choose to work a lot, have to travel a decent amount, but I love the position that I'm in poker, love having the deal with WPT, want to play as much as I can, love traveling. So I'm on, you know, kind of a different schedule as a poker player than my girlfriend is, who's a nurse practitioner, and we have her two little girls from a previous marriage that live in our house, and you know, occasionally I do Dad Brad stuff. They call me Dad Brad. So, like last night, I played a poker session at Bellagio from noon to about 6 p.m. Then I went and picked up our 12-year-old, her name's Emma, from soccer. I watched her play for about 45 minutes and then drove her back home. So, I try to do that kind of stuff. I actually like really love going to their soccer practices and their soccer games. I played soccer pretty much my whole life, and love seeing them progress, and love like cheering them on and everything. But I mentioned on a previous stream, my girlfriend of 5 years is pregnant. We're having a boy who's due in March, so I've got a crib that's in a box that I need to put together. We got it right before I left for Thanksgiving, and I was gone for 10 days. But now that I've been back the last couple days, I have opened the box, but I haven't assembled the crib, so I need to do that the next couple days. And you know, when my son's born, just want to be as good of a dad as I can be. So, can probably be playing online more and more going forward, which I'm excited about. Love like kind of playing online. Like being able to play from home is amazing. And showing you guys a different kind of more all-encompassing view of my overall strategy with poker. Another song by Petey in the mix. Eric Schmidt says you should come to a meetup game in Chicago. Where's the love for the Midwest? Yeah. We've done some awesome meetup games in Chicago. We had one of our biggest ones ever was actually out there, which is cool. But we haven't been back since before COVID. We did go to Detroit maybe last year and had a big hometown meetup game for Andrew. So that was awesome. Went to the MGM property out there. Gotta get a haircut today at some point, guys. not looking good. Hard to make my hair look good anyway, but particularly tough when it's long like this. I wanted to get a haircut before Thanksgiving, but everybody wants to get a haircut before Thanksgiving, and it didn't work out. Jiggities for like the fourth time in the last... We got to get this guy. We got to get this club guy. We're three betting it. We can't be... We know that he calls big three bets. He's coming after us. We're not letting go of second pair if it comes king high again. If he stacks us, he stacks us. So be it. Time to get revenge. And no... No king high this time. This is the one, guys. Kind of had to bet on the bigger side, like half pot or more. Maybe even like two-thirds would have been better because we don't want to see... Well, we don't want to see a flush card. And we don't want to see overcards come out. I really hope he doesn't have spades. Like, spades seems pretty likely. Like, we might just get stacked here, guys. But against this guy, knowing what he's capable of, we're coming for him. And maybe are gonna lose. Maybe are gonna lose. You have to be okay with that. Queens on the other side. All right, let's see what he called this with. Jack nine, wow. Laid down top pair. So played that one pretty good. Tried to get value while we could. Had a hand that I would have expected to kind of get a call from. This is a tough situation here. Might just have to cold four bet rip this one, guys. Like raising to any kind of smaller amount just puts us in a whole nightmare of situations where there's no snap call, so that's good. So we've got the best hand. So that's good. But yeah, if we raise to a smaller amount and like, let's say we raise it to like 3K or whatever, he's getting 2-1 on a call. Then we have to play out of position, and it comes ace or king high, and we're going to feel obligated to get it in, having no idea where we're at. I think we can still get called by like jacks, potentially. It looks even like a little bit more bluffy when we jam in that spot. Looks like we've got maybe ace king or something, so we can get called by potentially ace king or jacks in that spot, and we really deny equity from... Other ace high hands that are going to be potentially three betting light. Rye NY Fishing says, how do you start dating a girl with two grown children? We were dating, and yikes, he added at the end. Well, they were 7 and 5 when I first started dating my girlfriend Amber, and I thought she was well worth any kind of initial troubles that come with dating someone with kids. And I loved the girls. It was tough. It was tough at times, especially with the younger one. The older one was always kind of the peacemaker and would always try to make things easy for me. So, but sometimes the younger one, I really had to work for her love and affection and her trust. Coming in just some random dude that her mom's dating, you know? And I remember like certain instances where she would say, Mom, can you tell Brad to go home? It was just like brutal and broke my heart because I always just wanted things, you know, her to want to be around me. So when I would hear something like that, it was just like soul crushing stuff. But since then, you know, over the last 5 years we've been together and, you know, we've been living together for the last year and a half. She has, or I have gained her trust, and now like I love playing with her and she loves hanging out with me and messing around with me. She's like a little prankster and she loves to like jump out at me when I come home from playing poker and stuff, just to scare me, and loves to, she actually like likes to roughhouse a little bit. So she likes when we do little tickle torture matches and things like that. I'll take her by her ankles and kind of drag her around the kitchen, and she loves like doing that. and love playing soccer with him in the backyard and all that stuff. So yeah, we have a great relationship now. So I think that not dating someone just because they have kids is like super brutal, man. I don't think that's going to create a very good society if there's going to be a lot of single moms out there. We're going to call this one off one time, see if he slows down on the turn, see if we get a spade, and that's a beautiful card for us. So we have removal to 5-3, for instance. We have so many cards that can help us. We are going to go ahead and raise here. Hope that he doesn't have a set. See what he has. 7-10. Yeah, you're just kind of trying to be a pest. But yeah, I love the fact that I'm dating someone with two girls, and it is and it has been hard at different points. But I love that I've been patient throughout the whole process, and it's worked out really well for everyone throughout all the hard times. Awesome flop for us here. She's gonna bet 1/3 pot. Really not a great flop for his range as the caller, since with two high cards, like, he's not gonna have aces, queens, or ace queen. Best hand he's gonna have here is pocket fours. Maybe he can have ace four. We have removal to the flush draw. He might just rip it in here. We're gonna have to call off. Damn, I was kind of hoping he was gonna rip it. I'm gonna bet a little bit here just to see if he'll bluff it off. It looks like super weak, right? If I bet 140, and he might be like, oh, maybe I can bluff him off of a queen or something. But I'm gonna be snap calling. And if he has his beat, like, good for him. But he has absolutely nothing, which I kind of thought might be the case also, which makes me like that small bet even more, because he knows we just owned him. And if he has absolute air, then he has to have that opportunity to bluff. And if we check, he can just check back and think that, you know, maybe he'll win with like king high sometimes, like king 10 or something. So that tiny bet, this is like a little nudge. All right, we do have to hide this guy from the channel. Mr. Castler says, any free material or paid poker books you'd highly recommend? Yeah. The course by Ed Miller, that one's probably the most helpful for any player between 1-2 and 5-10. Wow, we got aces in a bomb pot. What a terrible time to get it. Fuck, this is like really, really bad. Because we're going against 7 opponents. Who all have uncapped ranges. So we could be up against 6-3, Jack-3, Jack-6. Like, you hope to just take this down on the flop. If he calls, that's fine, because he has a small stack. You don't want, okay, this is a dream spot. We're just, because now we rip it in, we know that we're capped at a $2,000 loss maximum. If he has a jack here, he might call. There aren't really any draws that all have, except for 5-4. Just got to fade an 8 or jack, and we do. So that works out as well as possible when we're just facing the small stack there. Thanks, guys, for just hanging out and tuning in today. How long have we been doing this for? Been playing for an hour and 45 minutes. Pretty awesome. Lucas Gadke says, getting married in April 2024. Will you be in Vegas January 6th through the 8th for my bachelor party? Yeah, I'll go to your bachelor party. My buddy's coming into town, I think that same weekend. I believe that's like the first weekend pretty much of January. And my friend's coming into town. We're going to watch the Niners games together. So I'm going to try to clear that part of my schedule to make sure that I'm in town for that. And then, yeah, if you reach out to me, you can send me a Twitter message. That is where, actually, I think now you can't unless you're verified or something. So send me an email, bradowen4@gmail.com, about the bachelor party stuff. I can't guarantee it, but I'll try to say hi. Seems pretty fun. Just not going to be doing any heavy drinking or anything with you guys probably, but pretty happy to meet up to make that bachelor party a little more fun. Ace Jack offsuit in the big blind. These offsuit big cards are kind of tough to play sometimes because you're going to be inclined to 3-bet them. Here, I'm just going to raise big. This is a limp pot so far. It's a bit suspect of a 4-bet, but like Ace Jack. Like I think that he's going to be doing this with some suited wheel combos, like ace 5, ace 4, suited type of stuff. Maybe like pocket 10s, 9s, hands that we have a bunch of equity against. But I'll just look for a slightly better spot. Yeah, king, queen. That's frustrating. He just puts in the cold 4-bet, gets me to fold out the best hand. So good play by him. $15.60 watching right now on the stream. We are well into it. Appreciate you guys hanging out, watching. Let's see, we'll be doing, yeah, new vlog tomorrow, 10 a.m. Be sure to check that one out. I'm gonna be firing. I've already got 8 videos made for the channel for December with the help of WPT Global hiring the editor. So, really excited to release like 2 to 3 a week, and then you know if I'm able to, I'm planning on firing just a ton of tournaments this in December for this WPT series. Just the coolest series, the best one of the year in my opinion, most well run, $40 million guarantee, just obliterates the biggest live guarantee in poker history, which was $15 million last year for the same event. And so I won't have a ton of time to actually like write scripts. So I'm glad to have like eight vlogs kind of done before the month almost starts. And then maybe I'll still be able to make like 3 or 4 other ones and I'll try to release those in December as well. And then we'll be all caught up. And then January, I'll be releasing them as soon as they come out. The reason that I wanted a bunch in the pipeline that were like 90% completed for December is because December has the best YouTube ad revenue leading up to Christmas. So advertisers are willing to pay more. It really helps to increase revenue by pumping out as much content as possible. And then January is the worst month for YouTube ad revenue. So typically it's best to kind of play as much poker as I can and film as much stuff and kind of release more vlogs during like February or later months, but not release as many vlogs in January. St. Joseph, 10 bucks. Brad, love the videos. Thanks for always dropping some knowledge for beginners like me. Struggling with bankroll management right now. Grinding 1-2. Any advice? I mean, if you're playing the smallest stakes available, then that's all you can really do, right? I would maybe suggest, like, depending on where you are, playing like micro stakes online or playing, you know, with your friends for like $5 or $10 or something, if you have that option. That way you just don't really, you can learn a lot, risk very little. Always like studying is good, you know, reading books, the course by Ed Miller, anything by Ed Miller is actually really good. And then once you kind of have a little bit of a foundation, joining the training sites where the best content really is these days. I have links in description boxes for training sites with discounts, but occasionally there's like free trials and stuff for training sites. So take advantage of those. Upswing, I know, gives preflop charts out either for free that you can download or for like $5. That's really understanding preflop stuff is very, very important to just get your fundamentals down. Because if you don't understand preflop ranges, then it's just going to make poker really, really difficult. So I'm betting 1/3 pot here. Might be able to fold out other hands that have equity like King Jack. But he just snap calls. So I feel like he kind of has like a 6 or 5 or maybe a flush draw. A king is going to be better for my range. I think he's just going to be calling me down though. But I feel like a double barrel is going to be pretty good here. It's going to work a good percentage of the time. Especially if he has a 10, like ace 10 or like jack 10. That's not going to be great for him. Wow, he only has 3K. Shit. So, yeah, let's see if he has a 10 or a 6 or 5 or something. 4-3. So that's the kind of stuff that you see on this site that you just don't see on other sites, where the dude is just calling from the button with 4-3. Sorry, he's calling from the big blind with 4-3 offsuit when I raise preflop. Like, that is the stuff that makes this site infinitely better than the same stakes on every other site. This is the equivalent of 10-20, basically. I'm just gonna go ahead and check this back. I don't really wanna get blown off of our flush. If we hit it, it'll be a little bit more secretive, but this guy also, now I'm actually gonna bet because ace is good for us, obviously. And we get, like, if he folds, like, jack high here or something. So he gets, we get him to fold bottom pair in that spot. With 3 Broadway cards out there. Just better for us. Like, we know that he called a 4-3 offsuit in the previous hand. He's going to have, like, some 9 high hands that are ridiculous. I will just let him have this one, I think. Or if we get to showdown with ace king high, that's pretty good as well. He could be bluffing us, very possible. But we could be drawing dead. Let's see it. Yeah, he just flops the flush and we get away from it. So it's good to know that he plays some of those hands tricky. Josh Gavin, brand new. Love brand new Sick Transit Gloria. Me too, man. Brand new was my favorite band for a long time. I still love, like, pretty much everything that they've ever put out. Robert Altman says, what's the poker bankroll manager app that you use? I use one called Poker Base. It's free. Bomb pot, ace nine off. We do have a removal to the nuts. And we do have a backdoor flush possibility. I'm just gonna, this could be an interesting one. What if, damn, shifted that so much. One third pot is $140. I mean, if I had a real hand here, if I really had 9-8, I would, I might bet it. Like if this checks through on clubs, we might just bomb. Yeah, well, we do have removal to that straight now as well. Ace, queen, queen nine, and 9-8. Plus if a flush card comes, the problem is we don't have removal to well, whatever, we'll just play this one small. Adam Stevens says, but can you make any money doing that with the rake? I mean, today I'm up several thousand, a couple, maybe like 2,000. I think I started the day with about $35,000 to $36,000. I've got like, I don't know, 1,800 here at this table. Got another 1,400 the other table, 3,500. Yeah, I'm up maybe like 1,500 or so, I think today. I lost that big one at the queens versus pocket aces. I was up almost 3,000 at one point. But yeah, you can definitely make money on this site with the rake. James S. says, that feature is absurd, LOL. Like, come on. He's talking about the hand reveal feature. I think it's great, especially for a live stream. I can show you guys exactly what people have. Everybody has the same access to that feature. And I mean, it's honestly, I think it's really fun for the recreational players. And even better if you're actually like a skilled player, because if you have that kind of information and you're able to use information better than others, then it works out well. We have two playable hands here. We folded in that pocket nines table. Folded to the three bet here with the queens. Rye NY Fishing says, obviously you're not making money in micro stakes, but you're certainly not losing money, and it is fun at times. The players are surprisingly disciplined. I'm usually drunk, he says. So I guess I think the other question was earlier, can you even make money with the rake when you're playing small stakes? I think that wasn't actually a question for me. It was a question in the chat about playing small stakes. Yeah, you probably can't really beat the rake in those small games with the rake. But those stakes are for getting better, you know, and improving your game. So that way when you do step in, like if you're playing for $5 in a, like, or if you're playing for $10 in a 5 cent, 10 cent game, and then you get good and you're beating those stakes, or like doing well, or even like breaking even, you're probably good enough to beat 1-2 live. And so I'm gonna do like a little delayed c-bet here. I'll just fold. So then that way, you know, when you're playing live for $200, $300 or whatever, you're just way more prepared. Otherwise you have to show up to the casino and play 1-2 against the same skill level of opponents that are playing 5 cent, 10 cent, and you're losing a lot more money as you're learning the game. So highly suggest playing for small amounts or even for free on like different apps if you have that ability. But yeah, playing with your friends is the most fun way to learn. That's how I learned. when I was in high school. Michael Nearhood says, do you ever bet on any sports games? Very, very rarely. In my opinion, it kind of takes out some of the fun, to be honest. I love the Niners. I get so into the games anyway that like I don't want to bet on those games. I would bet on the Super Bowl, any kind of big game like that, just to make watching those games where I don't have any interest in either team necessarily more fun. All right, guys, we're closing in on the 2 hour mark. I'm gonna probably wrap up here soon. I think we'll click out of this game since four-handed against guys who I know are good. How to Fold is a good player. So, book a small profit in that one. And then, actually, I don't think we profited in that exact table or in that stake since we were in for two buy-ins, two 10K bullets on that one because we lost the queens versus pocket aces. Maybe we'll get into like one more interesting situation and then call it a day. But yeah, I appreciate you guys watching. Keep checking in on the channel throughout the every couple days when I'm putting out new content. Chris Hayes says, what influence does the length of an opponent tanking have on your thought process when playing online? Kind of depends on the action and the board texture and a lot of things. So I don't think too much about it. I think it generally means they have a tough decision. Could be a tough decision between, you know, maybe they have the nuts and they're debating whether or not to raise or playing trappy, or maybe they've got something they're considering bluffing with as a re-raise or folding. Can't really always tell too much from them tanking, but I guess in general it probably means they don't have like a super strong hand all the time. I don't know. Mr. Kassler says, gotta go to sleep. Good luck, Brad. Can't wait for the vlog tomorrow. Awesome. It's gonna be yeah, it's not actually that great of a vlog. It's like a medium vlog. I'll just be tell you guys the truth. But it's always fun. The vlogs that aren't as good, like if the action isn't quite as interesting, I try to make them more entertaining by including more jokes. But if I'm playing like a high stakes session, and there are some high stakes sessions coming up that will be released soon on the main channel, those ones are so interesting and exciting that I don't feel like I need to go out of the way to like jazz those ones up and stuff. You know, if you're playing like $10,000 pots or more, those ones are just those situations are just so interesting to me anyway. And when I'm in the session, the adrenaline is kind of like so high. But I hope that comes through in the vlogs too. I try to convey as much of that as I can in the vlog, just how the nerves are present and the juices are flowing and all that stuff. Silent Asian 72 says, are you in Las Vegas? WPT is not allowed in the US? Yeah, I'm whitelisted as a WPT global ambassador as long as I'm not depositing or withdrawing from inside the US. I was told by the legal team there aren't any issues with it. So showing off the product, promoting the site. And then I have to go out of the country if I want to withdraw the money. All right, guys, probably play for about 5 more minutes or one more big interesting hand. This is a borderline one. ace 10 offsuit. I think with the antes and everything, it's probably just maybe closer to a pure raise, but do flop middle pair here. Just kind of keep this pot small, try to fold out some equity, check back turns once we get called. I do expect this player, that's actually a really good card for us to barrel on. Nothing gets there, doesn't connect. Could be up against a jack, but I'm gonna bet one more time. That way we can charge draws that, like, if they miss, aren't gonna put any more money back in the pot. Still expect to get called by jacks that are beating us, but then we can check back rivers. Whereas if I checked turn and the opponent bet, let's say the river's another four or something, he bets with a jack, I'll feel inclined to call off and it could be a bigger amount. So kind of betting to deny equity and also lose the minimum when we're behind. Gabe Couch says, hey Brad, I missed you in Playground. Do you have footage of the game you played there? Yes, I do. So that was at the end of October. That vlog is going to be coming out Monday. So just needs to catch up a little bit. So video coming out Friday, video coming out Monday, probably every Monday and Thursday going forward in December, there will be a vlog. Chris Offer says, wanted to sleep, but saw you were live. Very cool. Thanks for hanging out a little bit extra longer, or staying up a little longer. Chris Costanza asks, how long have you been playing poker? I've been playing poker since I was 14 or 15. My dad was in the casino industry. He was part of a management company that would basically flip rundown card rooms in California. So he took home this CD-ROM game called Hoyle Casino, where you could play against simulated opponents in limit hold'em tournaments. You play seven card stud as well, I believe, maybe some other variants on there. But yeah, I just would come home every day after school and play that. You could play all the other casino games on that CD-ROM as well, but the poker was what I enjoyed the most. And I was 15 in 2003, so my dad working there and then having poker just blow up with Moneymaker winning the main event and the lipstick cameras and online poker, putting a ton of money into poker TV shows and poker production. It was just kind of a perfect confluence of events that blew poker up in the early 2000s, and I'm a product of that. Let's make one set before we go, guys. I don't think we made any, have we made any sets today? M. Nolan 334 says, be honest, do you Google your one-liners because they're incredible? Sometimes I will Google something. Let's just call for fun, guys. Damn it. Sometimes I will Google like some aspect of it. Like, I'll have the concept in my mind. Like, let's say I have an idea that I know somehow. Like, let's say, like, I need to donate more money than, like, what's that movie where the guy inherited a bunch of money? Richard Pryor. Fuck, what is that movie? Where he inherits a bunch of money and has to spend it all. So I might, like, Google how much was Richard Pryor's character allowed to donate to charity in X movie. So like I'll Google those details, but like the thought or concept of it kind of has to be in my head already to even come up with a Google search, you know. All right, guys, Jiggities, one last time. This has kind of been the hand of the stream, and we're getting it all in against Mustapo. Perfect way to end the stream. Let's just win with it once. Like the flop. Turn gives us a sweat, a 10 or spade that's not a jack, gives him the win, and we get the victory. Woo! All right, perfect way to end it. We're going to go ahead and get out of this one now. Started the day with about 36,000. Whoa, my computer just fell in the background. I think a ghost. That's not good. This is the computer that I use to actually make vlogs. This is the one for streaming, but all right, we're going to go ahead and check out. Where we're at. So started the day with 36,000, ended up winning about 2,000 overall today between a variety of different stakes. You guys saw how nuts people were playing. You know, I'm not like perfect fundamentally. There's plenty of mistakes that I make all the time, but as long as I'm making fewer mistakes than my opponents, we can end up winning in the long run. And there are guys making like some massive mistakes in relatively high stakes. So a lot of the time online is tougher than it is live, but like when we're playing online 10-20 on this site, we're playing against people who are like have the same skill set as 1-2 or 1-3 players. It's pretty nuts. So pretty happy to share with you guys how I play overall. And just had a really good time. So hope you guys enjoyed it. Don't forget to hit the likes and subscribe buttons if you haven't yet. And don't forget to be on the lookout for a lot of vlogs on the main channel and actually a ton of content on the secondary channel called Brado and Clips. I'll just be putting out tons and tons of stuff. Thank you guys very much for coming and hanging out. And hopefully I'll see you guys on WPT Global.